Yes, is my screen is visible to you? Those who are joined, please respond. Is it visible or not? Nagaraju, Vishal.
Visible.
Visible. Right.
Fit for the purpose. Now, metrology has three basic activities. The first one is defining the internationally accepted units of measurement, for example, length, time, etc. Then, realization of the units of measurement in practice. For example, we have defined the length. Now, how to realize it so that we can use it for the commercial purpose or for the benefit of the society?
So here, as I told you, first of all, this international statutory bodies, whichever are there, first they will define what is a unit of measurement. Then for that unit, they are going to give us a precise quantity of object. If it is a meter, they are going to give a standard measurement for that one, okay, in terms of 1 meter bar. So then after establishing traceability linking measurements made in practice to reference standards. So after that standards, those are going to be that measurements whichever are there, they are going to be unified or uniformly, whether they are acceptable in each and every place or not, that we are going to concentrate. That means uniformity of the measurement. So first thing is, first they will made up, they go with the unit measurement, then after standardization of that measurement, then uniformity in the measurement. So with these concerns, every metrology department, every metrology wing, whichever is there, they will look after all these particular things. That is, first of all, internationally accepted units are going to be introduced. Then after further units, standard material standards are existing or not, they will look into that particular aspect, and they will look after whether that standard measurements whichever are there, they are uniformly acceptable throughout the world or not. Okay.
Then establishing traceability linking measurements made in practice to reference standard. That means whatever instruments we make should be comparable to the national and international standards. Now, metrology has the following three basic subfields: scientific or fundamental metrology, applied, technical or industrial metrology, and the third one is legal metrology. Now, let us understand these three subfields. The first one is scientific or fundamental metrology. So this deals with the establishment of quantity systems, units of measurement, the development of new measurement methods, realization of measurement standards, and transfer of traceability from these standards to users in society. In India, National Physical Laboratory is the custodian of various primary standards. Now we can see this photograph, which is concerned with thermal imaging metrology for healthcare. Lot of research work is going on in the thermal imaging, which is used to detect cancer in earlier stages, or the fever scanning, or the healing process in the body. So such research activities and establishing corresponding measurement methods and measurement standards is the activity which is carried out in scientific metrology. What kind of measuring instrument should be used for such newly developed methods? What kind of environment should be provided? Whether any specific conditions are there with regard to temperature, humidity, pressure, or any vibration proof datum surfaces are needed? And how to conduct the measurements, what are the guidelines for conducting the measurement process, how to report the measurement results. These are some of the activities which come under scientific metrology. Now we will move to applied, technical or industrial metrology. It deals with the application of measurement science to manufacturing processes and their use in the society. it ensures the suitability of the measurement instrument selected and their calibration and quality control of the products. So in this area, emphasis is given on the measurement themselves and traceability of the calibration of the measuring devices to ensure confidence in the measurements. We can take the example of this drawing and we'll try to understand more about industrial metrology. Now you can see in this figure, we have various parameters to be measured, like diameter of the component. There are three holes of different diameter. There is one bigger hole at the center. And then we have depth that is to be measured. Recess is there for which we have to measure. The depth of the recess or width of the recess we have to measure, and various lengths we have to measure. And there is a threaded portion here. We need to measure the thread elements like pitch of the thread, flank angle, measured diameter, minor diameter, etc., etc. Now, to measure all these parameters, we need to select appropriate instruments. Sometimes we may require the measurement of parallelism between two surfaces, and then perpendicularity between two surfaces, and then what is the form of the drilled hole, whether there is any taper or whether it is bell shaped or drum shaped, or whether any out of roundness is there. Such parameters we need to measure, for which appropriate selection of instrument is necessary. So industrial metrology helps in all these activities. Sometimes we may have to measure inspection, we have to make inspection fixtures so that the inspection can be carried out easily. So all such things are carried out in industrial metrology. Now we will move to legal metrology, which deals with the activities which result from statutory requirements. It is concerned with legal requirements of measurement processes, units of measurement, measuring instruments and methods of measurement. To establish necessary rules and regulations on qualities and control of measuring method instruments and their use. Now, statutory requirements might arise from the needs of protection of health, public safety, the environment, enabling taxation, protection of consumers, and to establish fair trade. This helps in detecting frauds in measurement and to book offender for trials wherever necessary. Now, let us try to understand the forensic metrology, which is a part of legal metrology. This applies to forensic sciences. Forensic laboratories perform numerous measurements and tests to support both criminal and civil legal actions. The examples of forensic metrology activities are given below: the measurement of blood or breath alcohol content, the quantification of controlled substances, both for net weight and purity. For example, what is the purity of gold? So that can be checked in forensic metrology. Then length measurements of firearm barrels. So you can see here in this picture, we have a firearm barrel. The length of the barrel we need to check, the diameter of the barrel, the surface finish, the various, the form of the barrel we need to check. And then latent print examination, for example, fingerprint examination, question document examination, like to check whether there is any forgery of signature, and DNA analysis to establish biological relationships. Then 3D laser scanning of crime scene can be taken so that it can be visited again and again to study the crime scene. Now, the results of forensic measurements are used to determine if a person is charged with a crime, or may be used to determine a statutory sentencing enhancement. Now, there is another kind of method to measure, to characterize, etc. Design and develop new methods of metrological methods and new kinds of metrological instruments, which will be able to measure the tight specifications. Now, If we study this diagram, we'll come to know that whenever there is a new idea generated, a lot of R&D work will be carried out on that new idea that is generated, and computer-aided design and analysis will be carried out on that particular idea to develop various models and to prepare the drawings. Once the drawings are created, we move for computer-aided manufacturing, where we manufacture the components as per the computer-aided drawing that is provided using different kinds of inputs. Now, if the components are new type of components having very complicated structures or profiles, we have to develop new methods of measurement, new instruments for measuring that complex profile. So we should have innovative metrology. We should invent new kinds of instruments. We should invent new kinds of fixtures, inspection fixtures, so that measurement becomes, or inspection of the component becomes, fast and accurate. Now the metrology is also applied in the assembly and testing of the new products that is developed. Finally,
so here metrology, how it is going to be related with the innovation? Means if you are having a new idea, at that moment first it will undergo R&D, then according to the R&D directions, that is research and development directions, the CAD people, whoever are existing, they will manufacture the design for that new idea, and analysis is going to take place by means of some inputs, that whatever the ideology we got, that what are the models we are having, what are the analysis we have done on that particular product, with that it will undergo a manufacturing process by some inputs. So here, by means of computer-aided manufacturing techniques, if you are making the design, or if you are making the production of that particular innovation idea, at that moment there the features of that new product or new object, whichever is there, which will undergo new kind of shapes, new kind of measurements, new kind of structure. So at that moment, with the help of this innovative metrology, that is by making some kind of existing component over there, we need to go with the measurement part. First of all, we need to check what is the unit of it, then what is the standardized format of that particular object, and in what way that can be measured, or by what way we can make it as a uniform one. Okay, sometimes this innovative metrology, whichever is there, which will helpful for us in assembly and testing also. That is, whenever that particular product which we are manufacturing in the CAM, if it is having proper dimensions or not, that testing part which is going to be takes place by means of this metrology only. And finally, we will make the packing and dispatch of those particular things. So here, wherever the manufacturing is there, wherever the assembly and testing is there, there you need to go with the metrology. If it is a new idea, then innovative metrology, innovative measuring techniques, as a metrology people, we have to look into. Okay, so whenever there is a chance for you to get a job in metrological department, at that moment, being a engineer, you have to perform different kinds of innovative metrology techniques. You need to look into the innovative metrology techniques by the existence of the metrological instruments, and how good you are going to make that particular product, or how good you are going to make the instrument for the assembly purpose as well as for the testing purpose. So with that concern, we are having this particular slide, which is going to give us how a metrology is related with the innovation.
The components and product, plating shop, paint shop, at all places the metrological instruments are used. In such a big organization, the metrology will have many objectives. We will study some of the objectives. To determine the type of measuring instrument needed by the plant, and to ensure that they are well maintained in the plant by periodical calibration. Depending upon the type of activities going on in the shop, they have to suggest, the quality control department will have to suggest what type of instrument is required, whether in-process gauging is required or off-process gauging is required, what should be the range of the instrument, what should be the accuracy level of the instrument, and then any special type of equipments are needed. For example, I'll write a sketch here. Say,
Nafiz Ahmed, please respond. Nafiz. Nagraj. Any one of you, please respond. Who is your class here? Any one of you? Sanat?
Sir.
Yeah, please take the existing list, that is screenshot of participants, and send it
okay,
to
sir.
Okay?
Okay.
We have a component which has department will have to say the process capability increases. Will control techniques form of change features. We so whenever the customer are
okay. So here in the inspection point of view, we need measurements over here. So let us have a glance on these measurements also. Inspection point of view.
He will give what are the various specifications
yes.
of the product, what type of activity is required.
Please, Sainath or whoever is there who have taken the screenshot, participant list, you please send to my WhatsApp number. Okay.
What is the size? What is the weight? What functions are needed, expected out of the products? All those things he will explain. Now, before we supply the product to the customer, we should compare what are the specifications of the customer and what is that we are supplying. If they match, then only we should supply the product to the customer. Now,
so here, like this, whenever we are having a metrology, within that, basically, we are looking whether the product which we are manufactured or which where the production is happened, whether it is happened according to the customer desire or not. If at all, that measurements are not existing means we will go with the inspection part, and accordingly by making some of the machining processes we are going to get the final output of that particular object according to the desire of the purchaser or desire of the customer. Okay, so like this here, the need of measurement and inspection is there with respect to the production, right? So like this, these are the some of the things which we come across within the inspection part, like manual, visual, and automatic. Okay. So hope you have understood whatever the content, whichever is delivered so far, it is as similar as we discussed over there in our few last classes. Whatever discussion has happened, the contents are similar to that one. Okay. So here somehow we can conclude that in the introductory of metrology part, basically we are looking the contents like what is the need of it, what is the definition of the metrology, and what is the need of the inspection, and which kind of measuring techniques, measuring methods we need to follow, and in the process of measurement, what kind of instruments we have to choose, that is by going through the characteristics of the instrument, and if at all with the instrument, if you are going, what are the measuring errors we are going to get, and what are the measurement standards and calibration things. Okay, hope you have understood what is there in the introductory part of metrology with these particular contents. In the next class, we are going to start with the new topic which is there within our first unit, that is interferometry, or we can call it as an interferometer, right? Okay, so for today purpose, we are going to stop our discussion here itself. Any doubts so far regarding our discussion points? If nothing to discuss, I will stop the class here itself. We please all of you join for the next class, which is scheduled for you. Hope you are having now this ES class, Environmental Science class, for A section and B section. You please join over there.